So hello friends, in this video I would like to discuss with you different tips if you are planning to go for a trekking trip. So the very first thing you must get ready is the paperwork. So you must keep copies of your ID card in your bag, and it's better if you're having multiple copies of it. And moreover, you should also keep details of your emergency contact. They can help if some problem arises. Clothing is the most important part if you are going for a trek. You should have at least two sets of comfortable clothing plus what you are wearing. And if you are going for a fortnight long trek, you should have 4 to 5 sets of clothing. You can always wash clothes when you reach camp, so you should not be loading your bag with too much clothes because it will be getting heavy. In cold or rainy weather, the pants should be wind and water resistant. The top should absorb moisture that generates due to sweat. You see, whenever we move, whenever we walk, our body releases sweat. So our top, our clothes should be able to absorb sweat. And moreover, if you are going to a cold region, it's always better to carry a warm top, jacket and layers of warm clothing, because they will help you when it gets very cold. And moreover, in mountains it can rain anytime, so you should have a raincoat or a waterproof jacket which can save you from rainwater. Umbrellas are only useful in camps, but while you are moving, only raincoat or waterproof jacket can help you. You should also carry caps, sunglasses, gloves, depending on the requirement. Especially caps, you can have two sets of caps, one cap for sun and other cap for saving yourself from cold weather. You should have an eco-friendly shower gel that can help you to use it as a face wash or a shampoo, or you can also use it for washing your clothes. Shoes and socks. You must have a pair of good quality water resistance hiking shoes, and it's better you wear them everywhere. You can wear them while running, shopping, outing to get an idea of how they feel. Means you should purchase such kind of shoes beforehand, and you must practice before going for trekking. And moreover, such kind of shoes definitely avoid blisters and low toenails, because that's a very common problem when we go for trekking. And you should have good hiking socks that can wick moisture and keep your feet dry. So shoes and socks are second most important part if you are going for trekking. So you must choose them very wisely. The next thing is backpack. You always need to carry small bag containing your camera, snacks, sunscreen, water, etc. So it's always better to keep it as light as possible, because when we move in mountains, due to rain, your bag may get a little heavy. So it's always better to keep it as light as possible. And sleeping bag is also a good option to carry with you, because whenever you are going for camping in mountains, sleeping bag can save you from environment, cold weather and other such things. Eatables. You should have enough water and food during a trek. See, whenever we move, the body gets dehydrated. So you need to drink a lot of water. So you must have enough water with you. And as far as food is concerned, you should carry nuts, dry fruits, chocolates, because these are good sources of energy and protein. First aid kit. You must have a basic first aid kit that can have following things. Your first aid kit may contain a small roll of cotton, 3-4 cotton bandages, antiseptic lotion or cream you can carry, band-aids, pain balm or spray, pills for basic ailments like fever, insect repellent, sunscreen, salt for leeches. So first aid kit is also an important part if you are going for trekking. So you must have at least a small size first aid kit while you are moving for a trek. Other than these things, you should carry water bottles that you can keep refilling, because generally in mountains we get streams to fill water. So that's not a big issue. Water purifying tablets or suitable water filter you must carry with you, because sometimes because the water in mountains is full of minerals and that may not suit your body. So it's better that you carry purifying tablets. Whistle in case you get lost. So you must also carry whistle so that you can call others through whistle. You must carry a headlamp or torch with you because during night they can help you to move. You should have knife or multifunction tools, walking stick or walking poles. They help you while you move down from hills. Emergency shelter like a plastic tube tent can help you during rain and other such conditions. And you should have a map with you. You should not be dependent on your phone maps. It's better you should have a printout of the map, so that in case you get lost, you can get an idea where to move and how to move. But before all this, what you should do means before you are jumping, you are moving toward trekking trip, you should practice few things. First of all, you should start walking. Do some really long walks. You can start with small distance and gradually you can increase the distance. But because during trekking you have to walk for longer distances, so it's better you should practice your body according to that, and this walking will build your stamina also. Leg exercises you must do, and before going for trekking you should have a daily routine of exercising your legs. You can do cycling to build up muscles of legs. You can play games like basketball, football, badminton and swimming, because they definitely help to make your legs stronger. And if you are walking or moving in malls or doing some shopping, it's better to use stair climbing, because it will also help you to build up your calves and quads. And you should avoid lift or escalators. Mix up your training terrain. Avoid training on your level footpaths. See, generally in cities, generally when we go out, the roads are plain, footpaths are leveled. But while training yourself, you should also have walk or movement on tracks like mud, slopes, etc. So that your body gets practice, and prepare your feet, ankles and knees for the stress they will experience on the trip. So in this way, using such kind of tracks, you can prepare your feet, ankles and knees also. Prepare for all weathers. You should also making yourself ready for all kind of weather condition like cold, windy season, rain, warm, humidity. So before going for trekking, you should experience all these weathers in real life. So thank you very much. So this was a video in which I have discussed various tips and tricks you should observe while moving for a trek. So if you like this video, you must subscribe it, like it and share it with your friends.